Hello everyone, I'm ExtraCheesy87, and this is Let's Play Trails in the Sky, second chapter, part 2, or no, second chapter, part, like, 19. We did not, play 10 hours in part 1, by the way, or however long, I don't know how long we've been playing this game, it's hard to tell. I think my Steam playtime is a lot higher, because, I mean, I have just had this game, like, sit around for a while, because it has around, like, 12 hours. What does Steam say we're at? How do I check that? Oh, that's not what I'm looking for. Steam says we have played 16 hours. Not true, because, I mean, I do sometimes after I record a video, I'll get up and, like, walk around and take a break, and so it might just, like, leave the game running for, like, 30-plus minutes. We opened this chest. This is one of the other rooms we went, running through, and it had an attack 2 in there, and we're gonna see who to give that to. Give that why can he not use it? Oh, because he has an attack 1 already. I knew that. Oh, they're both fire courts only. So, I mean, we could give you flare arrow. I mean, we could also not do that, which is probably what we want to do. Are there any good fire skills you want to work towards? We got spiral flare. La Forte, we already have. Oh no, we have Forte. We don't have La Forte. Which. Napalm Breath. Like, okay, nothing really. Is there anything that uses fire in the other schools that's any good? There's A-Crest. Plus 30% ADF. And Lost Mobius. It only costs 100 EP. So yeah, that's. That needs. Some of these. Spells are very expensive. We could give you the attack, or would you rather have seal? Oh, so seal is like silence. Okay. And we could give you attack. That would let you cast Forte. It would give you Forte, and then I assume you have flare arrow, fire. You get Firebolt EX. That's pretty good. Does Oliver get anything? He just gets flare arrow, so we'll give it to her. She's got all the frickin' spells, dude. I thought Estelle had a lot of spells. And she doesn't even have all of her quartz equipped. Okay, so I think we've explored most of the rooms we skipped. I don't think I'm gonna be able to run past this dude. At least he didn't get preemptively struck. I got preemptively struck by one of these guys once, and they almost one-shot us, like, from 0 to 100. Because they have AT delay in attacks that can also put you to sleep, so they just, like, comboed me for, like, literally 5 minutes. It was a lot of fun. Got some spooky spiders. We probably do want to do some fights just to, get some CP. God, I'm so. Why does everyone miss all the frickin' time, dude? It's like my biggest pet peeve about this game is like how often you miss. When there's like really not that much you can do about it, you know? Like, you didn't kill either of them, did you? I mean, we're right next to the heel, but like really, Estelle, you couldn't kill either of them? I like how that dude walked like 1,000 miles to go hit Oliver. You think he's just gonna run and one-shot Oliver? Of course he is. Okay, he couldn't quite make it. Don't you dare miss, you piece of garbage. Thank you.
Nighty night, kitty cats.
Don't ever say that again, please. So, alright, we're gonna try and run past everyone. God, it's so hot in my room. It's like that weird temperature. Or my room gets really hot because there's not very good ventilation and my computer just runs hot, especially while recording. It's like 60 degrees outside. I could probably turn the air on. It's just like, you get into those weird situations where it's like, it's not really hot enough to turn the air conditioning on. Because, I mean, it is freaking January 3rd. Why is it so freaking hot anyway, dude? Do not fight the fluffy bat. I can't remember. Have we gone in here? We have not. Probably a monster chest. This is a monster chest. There's no way it's not a monster chest. It is not a monster chest. Wow. I am stunned. Did we not get a Genus blouse? Oh, we got a Genus blazer. So it gives an extra art attack and art defense. I think we'll give that to old Oliver. Oh, we didn't get this? I thought we went in here. See a kitten crawled up in the chest. Oh, it's so cute. As a result of acute kittenitis, you forget to take whatever else is left inside. What are you talking about? We're just gonna leave the kitten in there? So here's where we fought that boss monster. Hopefully we will not fight any of those guys anymore, even though I have a feeling we're gonna fight at least one more, because bad things always come in threes. Dude, there's so many rooms in this area. There's nothing in this chest, but you could imagine all the things that could have been. Could there be a weapon that gives me infinite attack? An EP a charge? Okay. Let's just sneak past a horsey of doom. Don't fight the fluffy bat, even though we probably should fight the fluffy bat. Zerum powder? What the fuck is that? Wait, what? Look, I know you think it'd be wonderful if we could just all loot infinite amounts of treasure from the same chest, but no. What is Zerum powder? Cures KO, heals all HP, restores 100 CP. Okay, so that's very good. Have to remember that's something we got in the back pocket. Check as many times as you want. Nothing will ever be in here again. Okay. Challenge accepted. Don't fight me, horse. But the only downside of having four characters is that it's so easy to get back attacks because your conga line is so extended that running past enemies can put you into quite some danger. I don't want to fight you, spider. I will fight Mr. Horse. And we do need some CP, especially on Agate. Oh, is this gonna knock? It's gonna knock him out of the circle. Maybe you knock him back. There we go. Aw, strategy, dude. And she doesn't have very much knockback, so hopefully this will kill everyone. Okay, it killed the spider. Oh, let's go. And, okay, that's perfect. Got him enough CP so that he can cast an ability or something.
Should have done that.
Okay. Dude, there's so many rooms. Please turn around. That's gonna kill, probably. Good job. I think these guys must have really high evasion or something, because we miss all the time against them. I mean, I guess it would make sense. They're like a dust cloud, but...
Piece of cake.
Anyone close to leveling up? Estelle's pretty close. Dude, there's so many rooms. You're opening them again? How naughty. Don't ever call me naughty again, dude. Okay. I guess we'll go backtrack to at least that other room that was near us. Even though, I mean, it's pretty rare that the monster chests have anything really super great in them. Granted, I mean, the best thing they can... Are you kidding me? I'm actually so mad. I mean, at the very least, we're getting some CP out of this, so it's not a complete waste. So get me out of here. Friggin' bastards. S tablet? How does the chest look at us? S tablet? Cures lowered statuses, heals 500 HP. Kinda garbage. Well, maybe I shouldn't say it's garbage, but healing 500 HP is so low. I guess you'd think of it, I guess we could think of it more as just healing lowered statuses and the HP is a bonus. We probably should go back and check every room, but I'm not going to. At least not yet. So is this going to be the real boss? Hey! Ooh, it is indeed a person. It looks like the dancing man, but, physical this time. So who are you? Welcome, my guest, to my humble, transient abode. I receive you with open arms. Your host will not disappoint, I assure you. A mask? Oh, we got some banger music going, dude. He's exactly as you and Polly described him, Estelle. So then, you are the ghost who has been disturbing Ruan? Indeed, I am Princess Claudia. Well, no, you're not Princess Claudia. She's Princess Claudia. It is the greatest pleasure to meet you in person at last. How do you know who Chloe is? Haha, my pet, there is nothing, no item or secret on this plane or above which I cannot take. But I am uncouth. I have not introduced myself to the guests. Allow me then. I am Enforcer Number X, the mysterious, gentlemanly, phantom thief, Blue Blanc. That is to say, Enforcer Number X of the Society of Ouroboros. Ouroboros? Ah, hell. Don't back up. Such murderous withering glares, I assure you, they are not necessary today. I am merely here to perform a simple, trivial experiment. Not even the slightest hair on my body has any intention of conflict with you. We do, though. An experiment? Wait, that's the black orb that Colonel Richard had, the gospel. Quite, except unless my eyes deceive me, this one is even larger than the last. Interesting. It's as he said, then. You already know of these. The gospel I hold is a new model developed for the purpose of experiments such as this. It has proven quite the aid in my tests over the past few days. Tests? What tests? What indeed, as they say, a picture is worth a thousand words. Allow me to show you in person. Is he gonna summon a monster? Oh, it's a ghost. No, it seems to be a projection of some sort cast into the air using that device. Never heard of such a device being invented. Naturally not. This is a hologram projector that we developed. Of course, the projector on its own can cast images a little farther than this, but with the power of the gospel, one can do things such as this. Is he gonna whack us? Okay. I mean, that's cool and all, but it doesn't really seem all that great. Well, the concept is clear enough, I think. The good citizens of Ruan received a once-in-a-lifetime performance. They should be thrilled. So this is all just a bunch of bullcrap pranks, then? Pranks? Such an insult to my performances. 'Twas a gift of enjoyment and distraction to a city suffering the stresses of a heated election. Can you not see the beauty of such a gift? Okay, man, I kind of get what you're doing, I think, but... Tell me, why'd you do all this? Why'd you scare so many people? What do you people, what does Ouroboros have planned? It's not my place to speak the purposes of the Grand Master, forgive me. Why I myself am here assisting in the plan, however, is simple. I have come seeking an audience with you, Princess Claudia. What? Your beautiful pride, which was on such magnificent display when you brought justice upon the old mayor? I agreed to participate in this plan to claim that beauty of my own. Oh, I have awaited this day on pins and needles for months. You cannot imagine my joy. What? Justice upon? You mean what happened with Mayor Dalmore? Wait, how do you know about that? I was a fly on the wall for that little event, or perhaps a shadow? Like this, for example? You was Daria? Yo, was the Phantom Thief? Wasn't that like a side quest? And like at one point where like he had stolen the candelabra, the candle thing? Do you think that was him way back then who was messing with us? A Phantom Thief, yeah, because I think it was called like something about the Phantom Thief. A Phantom Thief is in essence a worshiper of beauty. We chase it, we covet it, and that which is prideful cannot help but capture us. Princess, your pride has stolen my heart. Indeed, you have stolen the heart of a Phantom Thief. Ah, what sweet humiliation this is. My pet, how do you intend to atone for such a slight upon me? I don't really... He's so full of himself he's about to fall over. Sounds familiar, doesn't it? Oh, I beg you not to compare me to that! So you're an agent of Ouroboros? You aren't what I was expecting, but... If you're gonna try and hurt Chloe, I'm definitely going to stop you. Right, in accordance to the laws of the Bracer Field, you are hereby under arrest and charged with intrusion, theft, and a bunch of other junk. I've got a whole lot of questions for you, the gospel being just the start, so come quietly or we break your teeth. How boorish, arrest? Me? Well, it would be invigorating to have a little fracas. I did choose this place for a reason. I shall allow him to be your opponent, I believe. That wall over there is going to open up and reveal another mech, isn't it? Oh, God. Oh, shit, me. It's another of the Ring Guardians. What in the hell? What the heck is that thing? Some kind of armored centaur machine? Quite, it seems he was just the guardian of this place. Poor chap was half broken when I arrived. I repaired him out of the kindness of my heart, you see. Since he's here, I think he could serve as a worthy opponent, don't you? You've got to be kidding me. Here it comes. Okay. Oh, of course he's got an entourage. Oh my god, dude, he's so big. Well, how much HP do you think he has? Only 1500. Okay, he's immune to fire, weak to water. Well, he's immune to wind. Doesn't take damage from fire, weak to water. Okay. I know what to do here. We gotta kill the puppet fraggers. Well, no, we can't kill the puppet fraggers. Because he's gonna be super strong then. But we also have to kill them because they're very strong themselves. Okay, well, you did upgrade your quick draw when you leveled up last time. It still does no damage. Good to know. No, they're not going to be able to reach us, at least. And he should, now that big dude's going to get hit. I mean, granted, he's not going to take any damage, but... Because he resists the fire. Oh, that he can't quite hit the... And we could go for the Wild Rage. I think we will. No, I messed up. I didn't realize the crit was down here. I thought the crit was right here. Oh, they all lived with one HP. Oh no, and that was on the one we were casting on, so our cast just got interrupted, I think. Oh wait, no, it still gets redistributed. So he doesn't take any damage from fire. I have a feeling that we're dead. Call it. Oh my god, he can spawn in more. I don't know, dude. I'm just gonna call this a mulligan. Like, we're not gonna win this fight. I accept that we're going to lose. I'm just gonna try and learn as much as possible. Ooh, even our water does no damage. Listen. Kinda just wanna let him win and retry. I don't know, man. Oh lord, he coming. I mean, you could go for the clock down. I mean, give it a shot, dude. Worked. I mean, it hit everyone. And that hits all those guys. Maybe we can just at least kill all the horsies? I don't know, killing the horsies is also bad because of the death throws. But you can't not kill the horses or else it would just get overrun. Because he's got too much HP to... completely ignore. He's doing a super attack now. I don't know what that is. You don't have any CP. We do have some people who can interrupt. Like old, well, let's have Oliver interrupt and you go for the water spell. Or, I mean, you could interrupt as well. I think Flare Arrow's gonna kill. I'm gonna bank on it killing. Go for the Draguna Edge. Or, I should've probably, now that, well, I know that he's weak to water now, but I should've definitely equipped the Sapphire Talisman on someone. Giving us a little bit extra damage. I guess go for the Aqua Bleed. That did not do nearly enough damage. I don't know why I thought that was gonna kill. I thought that was gonna do like 800. I mean, we're kinda getting him. A little bit. Now the horse is definitely a problem. Thankfully he didn't faint us. Also go for the hurricane. Granted, I don't know, you're probably better off just building up CP. You can still happy trigger everyone.
My love, I give to thee.
Happy trigger is such a good ability, dude. At least for now. I have a feeling it's gonna fall off eventually. Granted, who knows how long Oliver's even gonna be in our party, because they do like to switch your party members out in this game. Now he's about to get the crit with extra attack, and he's doing a special attack. Goodbye, Agate. It was nice knowing you, dude. We can not get the heal. Well, we can get the regular heal off, but not the super heal. I think you gotta go for it. You gotta heal him, because otherwise he's gonna die to the horse. still almost died to the horse. Do you think Faint will... Okay, here's the play. So for Estelle, a firebolt. She did not get healed. I mean, it doesn't do any damage, unfortunately. What is it that heals Faint? Smelling salts her, and then she ults. Okay, that was a little like, sir. He's casting a spell. I never want you to actually cast that spell, so.
You're feeling lucky.
And there's no point. Well, I mean, Flare Arrow costs the same EP. Someone's getting wet. Oh my god, dude. Don't hit Oliver. Thank you. Go for the Draguna Edge. That means that he'll die to the spell. Just hit, like, call an ally. Don't hit Oliver. Goodbye, Oliver.
How could I fail?
I was kind of like, I didn't know, like, I should have healed him, but, or used his ult before he died, but... I was also like, it's not gonna do any damage. Now, one problem is we are running out of mana. Very, very slowly chipping him down. Did not expect him to do that. We should have bought more Azalea's Kisses.
We're good to go.
Yo, here's the play. You steal that and you get the 50 CP for yourself, so it almost pays for it. Am I the greatest player or what? By almost pays for it. It actually still used it all, but... Oh no. No one has CP. No one has CP. We have that one thing that gives CP and... We don't have, like, none of our food besides the Zeron powder gives CP. Okay, maybe Earthguard Agate? Hard to say. I think you just take this time, get an EP charge up on Estelle. So if nothing else, Agate won't, if you know this one-shots everyone, Agate will stay alive. None of this interrupts. Shit, dude. Go for the EP charge on Clo.
Take that.
I just, well, I mean, I'm really worried about this spell. Okay, energy blast. Oh, dude, we're all dead. Everybody lived. Okay, heal yourself. heal Chloe. Oliver has the CP for his heal. I mean, that attack is, it's bad, but it could be worse. And you can hit everyone.
My love, I give to thee.
Unfortunately, Oliver's still in one-shot territory, but... I mean, he's not calling in allies, which, I mean, I don't know. I mean, that's good and bad. Go ahead and heal Oliver. You're not doing that much damage anyway. Well, you're not going to get it off in time. Use a regular tear bomb. Now these three are all lined up, so that Stell can hit the fat multi-heals. Curse Blade, don't like that. Okay, that's an AoE attack. Did not know. But, you know, you're learning all the time. We still have one more clock down in us. I think we're getting him, dude. Then Agate's just, he's here to whack him and smack him. That's fine. Chloe gets the big fat heal on our CP. Isn't really a heal, but you know what I mean. Everyone unleashes the bleeds that are aqua related. 600. Then plus probably like 400 from Oliver, 300 from Estelle. Okay, 500, because Oliver's a beast. We're slowly getting. Remember, we have this ult. Okay, everybody's been delayed. Go for the aqua bleed, and then. Well, oh wait, I wanted you to ult first. Or get your hack off first. But yeah, go ahead and pop the ult. We've got him on the ropes. If we can just keep the aggression up, we've almost got him. Estelle's almost got her ult. That's like a free 700 to 800 damage. He's casting a spell. IDC spells only care sniper shot. We're not in one shot territory. We'll let him do this attack. He's mobile hurricaning. No status effects because we resisted. Well, there's the one, but don't care because we're casting magic. Just whack him. You're plus 10, then ult. Listen. Did like 900. Hup. And then finish him, dude.
Let me show you the true essence of beauty.
Okay, that went pretty well, dude. Clock down. Very good. Very good spell. Once again, thank you to the person who told me it's a very good spell.
Nighty-night, kitty cats.
Oh, that's so satisfying. Estelle learned a true pummel. I guess. Whew, we won, I think. Well, last time we thought we won against one of these things that got up like two more times. What a waste of time. Please don't make me fight this man. We're at 40 minutes, and a double boss fight here would just be awful. Really now, such a lack of elegance in your fighting styles. I'd hope for better. Well, if I'm oh no. The torches? What? Apparently, he did something to our shadows. Apologies, my guest, but I must ask that you stay still from this point forward. You seem surprised when Dalmor's treasure did this, however. But we enforcers, such abilities are trivial even without such crutches. Didn't expect this. Aw, scree call call, boys! Oh, okay. He just paralyzed him. Dude, how the hell did C get down here, dude? Your frivolous bravery is admirable, but I must ask you to remain still for a while. Ah, my Princess Claudia, you are now a prisoner to my desires. Oh god, dude. This is not one of those games. How does it feel, I wonder? Do not think this will break me. Even if you bind my body, you shall never enslave my heart. So long as I am myself, you will never take me. Yes, yes, those eyes. Those eyes that shine with such beautiful pride and say I will never break. That shine is what I desire. Ah, you are everything I hoped for. Hey, cut the crap, okay? Oh, Estelle, dude. She's gonna whack him and smack him. Creepy mask, dude. Really? I do not understand the beauty of this mask. You have a very dim understanding of refinement, pet. I ask you, be silent. Dude, Oliver, school him on style. My apologies. You simply made a very crude mistake. I'm afraid I couldn't help but give an innocent chuckle. Oh, this should be amusing in a way. Watching a pig wallow in mud is captivating. And what exactly is my mistake, Bard? I certainly wouldn't deny Claudia's beauty, not for even for a moment. Her beauty, however, extends far beyond the estimation your frail, tasteless aesthetic provides. You may approach her again when you have learned the first thing about beauty, Jester of the Grandmaster. Your words are bold in the face of death, Erebonian. But what gives a vagabond musician scum such as yourself any right to insult my sense of beauty? Choose your words very carefully, for they will determine your fate. Well, then I shall phrase them as a question. What is beauty? You disappoint. I expected more than such foolishness. Beauty is pride, and isn't light gleaming far above mortal cares. Indeed, can any other answer be allowed? I think not. Really, I can't even laugh at such an answer. True beauty, Blue Blanc of Ouroboros, is love! Dude, love and peace. What? Beauty only exists because people are brave enough to love. And without love, without the bonds of affection and camaraderie that bind us together, beauty is naught but a hollow illusion. The prideful and the humble both shine as diamond in love. Bah, child. What the fuck is this dialogue, dude? Love is a hollow illusion, you Claudius jungler? What? Beauty is an absolute. Its existence does not depend on transient human emotions. Yes, just as the flower that blooms on the highest mountain, unseen by man, remains beautiful in anonymity. Okay, I gotta take something to drink. This is destroying my voice. Okay. I've never been forced to listen to a more brain-rottenly stupid conversation in my life. I'm, not quite sure what to say about all this. Never would I have expected to find a proper rival in the ways of beauty amongst such ruin. Musician, give me your name. Oliver Lindheim, a wandering bard and hunter of love roaming to and fro in search of its perfect manifestation. Oliver Lindheim. We shall remember that name. Hey, I finally found you guys! Oh no. How in the hell did she get past the monsters? Dorothy? Oh, Dorothy, run away, please! Huh? Hey, a masked man in white clothes! You're the ghost, aren't you? You are! Well... Okay, say cheese! What? Scree! Wait... Maybe the light from the camera? Freedom? I can move again! Okay. I really don't want to fight this dude. At least not without being able to save. Please run away. The gospel! Also, I would like to end the video. We're at 46 minutes, dude. You have my thanks, my guests. You son of a, what are you gonna do now? I'm going to end our reveille for tonight. Forgive me if I seem an ungracious host. It appears, however, I mistake stock of my assumptions about you. I can see now why the Black Fang takes such an interest in you. The Black Fang? You mean Joshua? We are old acquaintances, in a sense. The reason you came to my attention at all was because I noticed that shock of black hair and those amber eyes with you. Though his memories have returned to the stage of his mind, I do wonder what he's rehearsing, where he's rehearsing. The hell was... Yeah, but like, I'd really like to save the game. I must now take my leave, my guests. The true plan has started, but I would gird yourself for long labors and suffering ahead if you intend to oppose us further. And I do intend to keep our little game going on the side. Till next we meet. He freaking boomed us, dude. I still can't believe it. It's like a magic trick. Most impressive. I suppose it behooves me to take him as my rival. We are so beyond worrying about rivals here. He may look like some pervo ballroom freak, but that power of his is not normal. Ouroboros, wasn't that Lawrence punk then? They're all way stronger than I thought. So the ghost incidents came to an end. The next morning, Estelle and the gang parted with Dorothy and returned to the guild. And then they let us save. Nope, they did not, because this game has no respect for me. The Society of Ouroboros. To be honest, I only half believed Cassius when he told me about a secret society up to no good, but... Well, here's a reward for completing the investigation. Shouldn't expect it to turn out like this, though. I'll have the resorts forwarded to Cass, Brigadier General Bright and the rest of the army immediately. Get the impression they're desperate for information too. It's been too long, my tongue has turned to mush. Those chuckle nuts made something like that hollow thing, whatever. Ouroboros is capable of more than we ever dreamed of. Not mention whipping out another gospel like the frickin' toy or something. The fuss about the ghost was little more than the whim of the man in charge, really. Blue Block, the Phantom Thief. He found himself in Enforcer Number X. Does that mean there's frickin' 9 more of these guys? Okay, yeah, Lieutenant Lawrence is one. I mean, we know Joshua was one once. So that's like 3 accounted for. We know Green Hair. He's one. Now... I don't know if, archaeologist guy, chairman or whatever, if he would count. The Black Fang. That's what Joshua called himself that night he disappeared. Joshua was also an enforcer, I bet. Why the hell was he level 1 when we got him then? It was just like that Phantom Fool. All those weirdly specialized skills he seemed to have make a lot more sense. Specialized skills? He just whacked people with his sword, dude. Oh, he was hiding. Oh, so he was hiding his power level? That doesn't make any sense because we were in life or death situations all the time. Do you know how many times I wiped against bosses and you're gonna tell me Joshua? Oh, he just wasn't trying. The Phantom Thief guy said the Society's plans had only just begun. Please let me in the video. If I had thought about it, I would have cut the video at the end of that boss fight, but I'm too far committed now. I bet you're right, though. They're starting to act in the shadows all over Lyra. Given that our little ghost bust is over, it might be wise for you to head somewhere else. Yo, do you think we're almost done with the chapter? I kind of figured we were still going to have to fight the dude. But maybe the chapter's actually done. The Zeiss Branch? Hell yeah, brother. The city with the best music, and we might get Tita back? Sounds like they're fairly undermanned at the moment. Will Ruan be alright, though? The Bose Branch is dispatching Sting! Who the hell is that? Oh, and once you get to Zeiss, you may want to check in Professor Russell. He might have an insight on the new gospel you guys observed. Yeah, that's a good idea. Totally want to see Tita again anyway. Well then, we should head for the airship port as soon as our preparations are complete. Jean, if you've been so kind, I don't think we're gonna get 4 tickets. I assume Chickadee's gonna stay? Pardon? Where do you get off taking the lead in? Hold on, 4? Well, naturally, you and Agate, and then myself and this Clover, of course. What? I thought thought this might come up, but you gonna come with us? Please. I'll take Oliver. Chloe probably needs to stay. The search for Joshua is my mission as a hunter of love. Not to mention the matter of my new rival. That should be reason enough, I would think. Okay, wait. Leaving your total friggin' insanity aside for a second? Don't drag Chloe into this too, you jerk. She doesn't even want... No. Actually, I was gonna ask the same thing. Hell yeah. If we can have four party members, I'm all for it. I just figured she wasn't gonna come. Because, you know, she's like a student princess thing. As what I am, I cannot simply ignore what they're doing. I must act. Besides, I want to help Joshua and you, Estelle. But your classes. This morning I sent a letter to Dean Collins stating that I will be taking a break from lessons. My exam scores are excellent anyway. Okay, nice humble brag. I have all the credits I need to move to the end of the year already. I talked to Jill and Hans about it and they insisted I should go. Yo, is the game actually going to let us keep our party members instead of just yeeting them from existence as soon as the chapter's over? I'm sorry, I suppose I am shoving myself onto you in a way. I can remain behind if you prefer. Okay, seriously. Game. Yep, the bird's great. Yep, she's going to help us out. Please, let me in. I shall assist you with all my heart. Let us be off. Okay, so that was the end of chapter one. I was kind of figuring it was going to be dude runs away and you have to track him down again for a final fight. But no, that was actually the end. Alright, so that's going to be it for this video, guys. Well, I'll wait for this cut for it to stop, maybe. Oh, there he is. Yeah, I should have cut it after we beat the boss, but I didn't think that scene was going to go on for 15 more minutes. I'm ExtraCheesy87, stay tuned for the next part, and bye, guys!